Hello friends, arbitrage is a trading strategy that has made billions of dollars as well as being responsible for some of the biggest financial collapses of all time. It is a forex strategy in which a currency trader takes advantage of different spreads offered by brokers for a particular currency pair by making trades. There are different spreads for a currency pair which imply disparities between the bid and ask prices. Currency arbitrage involves buying and selling currency pairs from different brokers to take advantage of this disparity. What is this important technique and how does it work? That is what I will attempt to explain in this session. Okay, so now let us talk about what is arbitrage. Arbitrage and value trading are not the same. Arbitrage is the technique of exploiting inefficiencies in asset pricing. When one market is undervalued and one overvalued, the arbitrager creates a system of trades that will force a profit out of the anomaly. In understanding this strategy, it is essential to differentiate between arbitrage and trading on valuation. You will often hear people say that when a security is undervalued or overvalued, an arbitrager can buy it or sell it and hence hope to profit when the price comes back to fair value. The keyword here is hope. This is not true arbitrage. Buying an undervalued asset or selling an overvalued one is value trading. The true arbitrage trader does not take any market risk. He structures a set of trades that will guarantee a risk-less profit, whatever the market does afterwards. Now, talking about arbitrage example. Taking the simple example, suppose an identical security trades in two different places, London and Tokyo. For simplicity, let's say it's a stock, but it does not really matter. The table on screen shows a snapshot of the price quotes from the two sources. At each tick, we see a price quoted from each one. At 8:05 and 2 second, the arbitrager sees that there is a divergence between the two quotes. London is quoting a higher price and Tokyo the lower price. The difference is 10 cents. At that time, the trader enters two orders, one to buy and one to sell. He sells the high quote and buys the low quote. Because the arbitrager has bought and sold the same amount of the same security, theoretically, he does not have any market risk. He has locked in a price discrepancy which he hopes to unwind to realize a risk-less profit. Now, he will wait for the prices to come back into sync and close the two trades. This happens at 8:05 and 5 second. He reverses out the two positions and the final profit is $1 less his trading fees. Not a huge profit, but it took just 3 seconds and did not involve any price risk. Arbitrage is a bit like picking pennies. The opportunity are very small. This is why you have either to do it big or do it often. Before the days of computerized markets and quoting, this kinds of arbitrage opportunities were very common. Most banks would have a few arb traders doing just this kind of thing. Okay, so let's understand cross broker arbitrage. Arbitrage between broker-dealers is probably the easiest and most accessible form of arbitrage to retail foreign exchange traders. To use this technique, you need at least two separate broker accounts and ideally some software to monitor the quotes and alert you when there is a discrepancy between your price feeds. You can also use software to backtest your feeds for arbitrageable opportunities. A mainstream broker dealer will always want to quote in step with the forex interbank market. In practice, this is not always going to happen. Variances can come about for a few reasons. timing differences, software, positioning, as well as different quotes between price makers. Remember, foreign exchange is a diverse, non-centralized market. There are always going to be differences between quotes depending on who is making that market. Talking about delayed quotes, when a broker's quotes momentarily diverge from the broader market, a trader can arbitrage these events. This will allow a risk-free profit. In truth, there are challenges, more on the later. Let's look at an example. The table on screen shows two broker feeds for Euro versus USD. Having both quotes available, the arbitrager sees at 1 and 1 second that there is a discrepancy. He immediately buys the lower quote and sells the higher quote, in doing so, locking in a profit. When the quotes resync, 1 second later, he closes out his trades, making a net profit of 6 pips after spreads. Okay, so talking about spreads, when arbitraging, it is critical to account for the spread or other trading costs. That is, you need to be able to buy high and sell low. In the example given before, if broker A had quoted 1.3038/1.3048, widening the spread to 10 pips, this would have made the arbitrage unprofitable. The outcome would have been entry trade. Buy one lot from A at 1.3048, sell one lot to B at 1.3048. Exit trade. Sell one lot to A at 1.3049, buy one lot from B at 1.3053. Profit minus 4 pips. In fact, this is what many brokers do. In fast-moving markets, when quotes are not in perfect sync, spreads will blow wide open. Some brokers will even freeze trading, or trades will have to go through multiple re-quotes before execution takes place, by which time the market has moved the other way. Now, spread range between two broker quotes as shown on the screen. Sometimes these are deliberate procedures to thwart arbitrage when quotes are off. The reason is simple. Brokers can run up massive losses if they are arbitraged in volume. Arbitraging currency futures. Anywhere you have a financial asset derived from something else, you have the possibility of pricing discrepancies. This would allow arbitrage. The forex market or the forex future market is one such example. Suppose we have the following quote. GBP per USD spot rate is 1.45. Now, 12-month GBP per USD futures contract trades at 1.44. 12-month interest on USD is 1.5%, whereas 12-month interest on GBP is 3%. A financial future is a contract to convert an amount of currency at a time in the future at any agreed rate. Suppose the contract size is 1000 units. If you buy 1 GBP per USD contract today, in 12 months time you will receive 1000 pounds and give $1,440 in return. The arbitrager thinks the price of the future contract is too high. If he sells one contract, he will have to deliver £1,000 in 12 months time and in return will receive US$1,440. He does the following calculations. To deliver £1,000, the arbitrager needs to deposit £970.45 now for 12 months at 3%. He can borrow in US dollars the amount $1,407.15 at 1.5% interest. He can convert this to £970.45 at the spot rate. The cost of the deal is $1,407.15 plus $21.27, 12 months interest at 1.5% which is $1,428.41. The above deal would create a synthetic futures contract that would convert £1,000 to $1,428.41 in 12 months' time. The cost today is $1,428.41. From this, he knows that the 12-month futures price should really be 1.4284. The market quote is too high. He does the following trade. Sell one futures contract at 1.44. Create the synthetic futures deal as already discussed. At the end of 12 months, under the contract, he delivers the £1,000 and receives $1,440. Using the money, he pays back his loan of $1,407.15 plus $21.27 interest. He makes a riskless profit of USD 1440 minus USD 1428.41. It will give a USD 11.59 profit. Notice that the arbitrager did not take any market risk at all. There was no exchange rate risk and there was no interest rate risk. The deal was independent of both and the trader knew the profit from the outset. The cash flows are shown as on the screen. Talking about value trade alternatives. Seeing the futures contract was overvalued, a value trader could simply have sold a contract hoping for it to converge to fair value. However, this would not be an arbitrage. Without hedging, the trader has exchange rate risk and given the mispricing was tiny compared to the 12-month exchange rate volatility, the chance of being able to profit from it would be small. As a hedge, the value trader could have bought one contract in the spot market. But this would be risky too, because he would then be exposed to changes in interest rates because spot contracts are rolled over nightly at the prevailing interest rates. So, the likelihood of the non-arbitrager trader being able to profit from this discrepancy would have been down to luck rather than anything else, whereas the arbitrager was able to lock in a guaranteed profit on opening the deal. Okay, let us now talk about cross-currency arbitrage. Trading textbooks always talk about cross-currency arbitrage, also called triangular arbitrage. Yet, the chances of this type of opportunity coming up, much less being able to profit from it, are remote. With triangular arbitrage, the aim is to exploit discrepancies in the cross rates of different currency pairs. For example, suppose we have broker A, where euro versus US dollar is quoted as 1.3000 and pound versus US dollar is quoted as 1.6000. This means we should have the cross rate of GBP versus euro is equal to 1.6000 upon 1.3000, which will give us 1.2308. Suppose broker B quotes GBP versus euro at 1.2288. From the above, the arbitrager does the following trade. Buy 1.2288 euro at 1.300 into 1.2288 US dollar from broker A. Buy 1 GBP at 1.2288 euro from broker B. Sell 1 GBP at 1.6 US dollar to broker A. His profit is 1.6 US dollar minus 1.3 into 1.2288 US dollar, which will give us 0.00256 US dollar. Of course, in reality, the arbitrager could have increased his deal sizes. if he trades standard lots, his profit would have been 1 lakh into 0.00256 or $256. The cash flows are shown on the screen. In practice, most broker spreads would totally absorb any tiny anomalies in quotes. Secondly, the speed of execution on most platforms is too slow. Now, let us talk about electronic markets' reduced price anomalies. Arbitrage plays a crucial role in the efficiency of markets. The trades in themselves have the effect of converging prices. This makes gaps disappear, so removing the opportunities of risk-free profits. Over the years, financial markets have become increasingly efficient because of computerization and connectivity. As a result, arbitrage opportunities have become fewer and harder to exploit. At many banks, arbitrage trading is now entirely computer run. The software scours the markets, continuously looking for price inefficiencies on which to trade. For the ordinary trader, this makes finding exploitable arbitrage even harder. Nowadays, when they arise, arbitrage profit margins tend to be wafer thin. You need to use high volumes or lots of leverage, both of which increase the risk of something getting out of control. The collapse of hedge fund LTCM is a classic example of where arbitrage and leverage can go horribly wrong. Some brokers forbid clients from arbitraging altogether, especially if it is against them. Always check their terms and conditions. Beware, because some brokers will even backtest your trades to check if your profits have coincided with anomalies in their quotes. Forbidding arbitraging is short-sighted, in my opinion. Seeing a no arbitrage clause should raise red flags about the broker concerned. Arbitrage is one of the linchpins of a fair and open financial system. Without the threat of arbitraging, broker dealers have no reason to keep quotes fair. Arbitragers are the players who push markets to be more efficient. Without them, clients can become captive within a market rigged against them. Let us talk about challenges to the arbitrage trader. Arbitraging can be a profitable low-risk strategy when correctly used. Before you rush out and start looking for arbitrage opportunities, there are a few important points to bear in mind. First, liquidity discount or premiums. When checking an arbitrage trade, make sure the price anomaly is not down to vastly different liquidity levels. Prices may discount in less liquid markets, but this is for a reason. You may not be able to unwind your trade at your desired exit point. In this case, the price difference is a liquidity discount, not an anomaly. Second, execution speed challenge. Arbitrage opportunities often require rapid execution. If your platform is slow, or if you are slow entering the trades, it may hamper your strategy. Successful arbitrage traders use software because there are a lot of repetitive checks and calculations. Next, lending or borrowing costs. Advanced arbitrage strategies often require lending or borrowing at a near risk-free rates. But once fees are added, traders outside of banks cannot lend or borrow at anywhere near risk-free rates. This invalidates many arbitrage opportunities. Next, spreads and trade costs. Always factor in all trading costs from the start. Okay, let us summarize today's session. Forex arbitrage is a risk-free trading strategy that allows retail forex traders to make a profit with no open currency exposure. The strategy involves acting fast on opportunities presented by pricing inefficiencies while they exist. This type of arbitrage trading involves the buying and selling of different currency pairs to exploit any inefficiency of pricing. So, we tried understanding 2-point arbitrage, 3-point arbitrage, as well as challenges faced by arbitrage trader. These challenges included liquidity discounts or premium, execution speed challenge, lending or borrowing costs, and spread and trade costs. I hope this session would have been useful in understanding international financial management better. Thank you.